are you looking for a job or you're looking to make a change early on in your career? You know, looking for a job can be very, very exhausting and can be challenging. And especially when you're a fresher where you don't have too much of experience behind you, it can be equally even more challenging. You know, so many candidates, so many students who've just passed out are waiting to start their career. And if there is a job post which has been advertised and suddenly, you know, there are loads of applications which the companies receive. So how is your resume going to stand out from the rest of the other candidates? Hello, everyone. This is Sonia. This is my Thinking Out Loud Thursdays. You with me over coffee. So let's get started with today's episode. Like I said, you know, resume is something that it's a document that reaches the employers even before you've had a face-to-face interaction with the employers. So your resume actually is giving a little background of who you are as a person, who you are as a person or as a professional. So it's very, very critical for us to prepare our resume in a way that it stands out from the crowd. Now, how do we do that? Because you've already got your educational qualifications, you've got the right certifications in place, you have the skills which are good enough for the company to hire you as a fresher. But if you don't have an impressive resume, how the companies would know whether you are worth even calling for a face-to-face interview? So let's get started in knowing what are the few things that you can do. Because in my career, I did make a resume when I started my career, because at that time, I'm talking almost like about 28 years ago. So at that time, we never had these technology oriented platforms where you could make. We used to just make it on a computer, take a printout, and that computers also were not that fancy laptops that we have today. So, but now today you have all the available resources for you to do a little bit of research as to what are the trending resumes that are being accepted by companies? Is there any format that the company is appreciating more or is looking forward to more? Then you can make your resume in that format itself. And then you have counselors in the college itself who guide you as to if you need help from them in terms of, you know, what are the things that you need to include in your resume. You can take their help as well. But today, let me share with you some of the things that I do when I'm updating my resume, or somebody is asking me for advice into how they can make their resume. So I hope you find this video useful. But before that, have you subscribed to my channel? If you've not done that, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, as I'm going to keep bringing such useful episodes for all of you. Yes, because see, please understand that your resume is a gateway to potential career opportunities. You know, and that makes it even more essential to create one that leaves a very lasting impact on your employers, right? So the first thing that you need to do is tailor your resume. It's not like it's a one size fits all types. So if you're applying for, say, a marketing executive role, or you're getting into sales, or you're getting into administration, or whatever line that you're getting into, you need to make sure that your resume speaks for the job description, and not because you have no experience behind you. So, you know, you're just putting in. No, you need to include certain keywords. So if in college you were head of, say, a particular batch, you were head of finance committee, or you were looking at events, or you hosted some events in the college, those are good skills to capture. Those are good accomplishments that you've had along your educational journey. So please make sure that you capture that, because that's very, very important. So please tailor your resume. Read the job description that has been advertised very clearly, line by line, and then see what in your background that you can bring forward that will make you stand out. So please tailor your resume and don't make it like a single resume and keep sending it to all the companies. Know about the companies that you're sending and then tailor it accordingly. Yes, that's very important. Number two, showcase your achievements and quantifiable results. So supposing you're making a career change and you say you managed a particular project or you managed a particular team, Instead of saying just that, you can say that you managed a team of three people or two people, which resulted in X percentage of increase in, say, whatever was the result outcome of it. Because the companies are more interested in what were the outcomes of what you were involved in, rather than just simply stating that you did this, 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 this. No, that is not what they want. They want to know from you what was the end result of what you did. So you need to please showcase your achievements, and what were the quantifiable results also you should mention about it. So even if you're a fresher starting, I'm sure in college and school you were part of some debates, some group discussions, you were part of some events, etc. So please make sure that you mention, and then how it benefited overall you as a person, or there were some results that were the outcome of it. Please mention that, because that's really going to make you stand out. So don't just tell what you did, instead show what you achieved. That's the main point that I wanted to emphasize. The third thing what you need to do is use some real good keywords and action verbs. So something like implemented, or innovated, or optimized, because when you're using the right keywords, that immediately catch the attention of whosoever is going through your resume, right? That's very much required, because that showcases your contributions, and that will stand out. So remember, the right word can spark curiosity, can evoke emotion, and can drive action. So please use some good keywords, but make it relevant. Don't just because somebody else used a keyword and they got a job, so you also start using that. No, you see your own path, your own journey, your own qualifications, what you did, what were your achievements, and similarly use those keywords which are relevant to the position also, or the company also that you're applying for, right? That's very, very critical. That's going to make you stand out. Yes. Now, the fourth thing that you need to do is keep it concise and readable. We are so excited about writing everything about our lives. मत करो ऐसे, ये नहीं होगा, ऐसे नहीं चलेगा. Because see, it's a document. If you're a fresher, then your resume should not be more than one page, one A4 sheet. That's it. Your resume cannot be more than, अगर ज्यादा ही करना है, बिकॉज यू आर इन्वॉल्व इन टू टू मेनी इंटर कॉलेज एक्टिविटीज एंड डिबेट्स एंड एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, सो यू हैव टू मेनी अचीवमेंट्स टू लिस्ट डाउन. सो मैक्स टू पेजेस, बट नॉट बियॉन्ड दैट सर्टनली, बिकॉज पीपल आर नॉट, बिकॉज इफ यू आर अ फ्रेशर, यू शुड नॉट बी गोइंग बियॉन्ड टू पेजेस. बट बेस्ट वुड बी इफ यू कैन मेक इट इन टू अ सिंगल पेज, अ सिंगल ए फोर शीट, राइट? सो प्लीज कीप इट कंसाइज, डोंट राइट वेरी लॉन्ग पैराग्राफ, बिकॉज पीपल डोंट हैव द टाइम टू गो थ्रू योर पैराग्राफ्स. सो यूज बुलेट पॉइंट्स, दैट इज वेरी मच, बिकॉज पीपल कैन रीड द बुलेट पॉइंट्स, राइट? एंड अ बुलेट पॉइंट ऑल्सो कैनॉट बी अ पैराग्राफ. अ बुलेट पॉइंट शुड बी मैक्सिमम टू लाइन्स वॉट यूर राइटिंग, एंड देन मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट बुलेट पॉइंट. सो यू कैन यूज अबाउट सिक्स सेवन बुलेट पॉइंट्स इफ यू वॉन्ट, एंड अवॉइड यूजिंग जार्गन्स दैट यू writing. So make it relevant to whatever company that you're applying and the position that you're applying, but keep it short, right? That is going to be making your resume more impactful, and people will appreciate whatever that you are mentioning in your resume, right? क्या फायदा इतनी लंबी स्टोरी लिखने का अगर वो सामने वाला आपका रिज्यूमे पढ़ेगा ही नहीं. तो सो इट्स नो पॉइंट राइटिंग स्टोरीज विच द अदर पर्सन इज नॉट गोना रीड. सो कीप इट कंसाइज, राइट? द नेक्स्ट वन इज दैट प्रोवाइड सम प्रोफेशनल ऑनलाइन प्रेजेंस दैट यू हैव. लाइक इफ यू ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड अ लिंक्डइन पेज, एंड इफ यू नॉट डन दैट स्टिल, प्लीज क्रिएट अ लिंक्डइन अकाउंट, बिकॉज दैट इज अ प्रोफेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म. एवरीबडी टुडे हु इज वर्किंग, they have LinkedIn accounts, and it's very much, it's credible. It showcases you in the right light, and you're building your brand. So people take it very seriously if you have an online presence. Say you started a blog when you were in college, or you started a YouTube channel while you were in college, or you've been doing a podcast, or you've written some newsletters. So if there's anything in the online presence that you have, please bring it onto your resume, because that's going to stand out and that's going to be very much appreciated by your employers, right? So please do that, bring it out. Next is you need to optimize for application or applicant tracking system, which is the ATS. In today's time, I remember at our time when I started my career, there was nothing like, you know, an applicant tracking system, because there were never like so many resumes sent, and even if there were so many resumes received by the employers, they had people in the HR department who would go through each and every resume and then they would call people for interview. But today, people are posting jobs online on LinkedIn Jobs. There is Naukri. There is shinejobs.com. So there are so many job portals which are today available where jobs are getting advertised and there are candidates who are applying jobs online, right? So the companies, when they advertise for a position, guess how many applications do they receive? They don't receive like 10, 20 applications. They receive like hundreds and thousands of applications. And it's not possible for a human to go through each and every resume with complete concentration, giving the due credit to each application. It's not possible. So how do they do that? They have an applicant tracking system which actually screens every resume, and there are some keywords that the resume which you've highlighted, that platform picks it up basis the job description that was advertised. So make sure that your resume is ATS friendly. Use the right standard fonts. Please don't get into fancy calligraphic or some other fonts. Use the standard fonts, font size. Don't use too many colors. Don't use any graphics, no logos. So please, and don't use anything in a box. You can outline your resume as a document. You can make that as an outline, but don't inside your resume, please don't put any content and put a box around it. It'll look very neat and tidy and it'll be very presentable. But if that company has an ATS in place, then, you know, making that presentable by putting boxes everywhere will disqualify you. So please read through, so there's enough material online available as to how you can make your resume ATS friendly. And if you want me to do a separate session on this, I can do that as well, right? So in make sure that your resume is ATS friendly, because that is required. And make your resume in a chronological sequence, which is like to bring whatever is your most recent qualification, bring it on the top, and the most the previous ones you take it at the bottom. So if you've done any internships and mention those internships, the most recent ones, put it on the top. What did you do? What was your value that you brought on table? How you contributed to it? Did you do a research report, etc.? Please bring it on, and but make it into a chronological sequence, right? Sometimes to pronounce these words is so difficult, right? Now, last one that I want to tell you is seek for feedback and proofread your resume. Kyunki hum itni jaldi mein hote hain na ki bana liya resume fatafat bhej do. Usme grammatical errors ho sakta hai, usme English errors ho sakta hai. So please make sure that once you've made your resume, go through it with a calm mind, have a cup of coffee if you want to, and come back and proofread your resume, and then give that resume to a few of your friends, or give it to your parents if they are working parents, give it to your neighbors or some friends, their parents, you can give it to them and see what is their feedback. Because since they're already working and they have years of experience, they can actually give you good feedback. And if you can actually tell them to run past that resume through their HR head in that company, wherever they are working, then even better, because then you'll get a first-hand feedback of any HR person who will give you a very unbiased feedback as to, you know, how your resume is faring out. So please seek for feedback and proofread your resumes, because that's very, very critical. You need to please remember that impactful resume is a reflection of your professional journey, nobody else's journey. So you need to make sure that your resume is very professional, is impactful, is neat and clean. You can make your resume into two columns also, which is now the trend, which is ATS friendly as well. And so which is like you make two columns. The left side column can be a little thinner one, and there is the right side column can be a little wider one, where on left side you can capture your date of birth, your education, where you did in whichever school, college that you went, and on the right hand side you can mention about, you know, what your aspirations are, what your skills are, what your strengths are, and then followed by in chronological sequence what your experience has been, whatever, if you got any awards or you won any debates, etc. So please mention that, and your you know, social presence that you have, like LinkedIn or any blog you've written, any newsletters you've written, or you've got a podcast running. So please mention that as well. So I hope this episode was useful for you. Good luck for your career journey. I really hope that you grow in life and do very well. Yes, on that note, I'm going to end my Thinking Out Loud Thursdays. Until next Thursday, please have a fabulous day, everyone. And I'm going to enjoy my coffee. But don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Yes? Bye-bye.